specialized stations as well. Mine are set up a little bit differently depending on what sorts of activities we're doing. Sometimes, like Sean said, I use it as a discovery. Sometimes there's been instruction and then there's practice that goes along with that. So we may do a couple days of instruction and then those stations are set up as practice for those students. Again, I usually have 3 to 4 students in a group. Yes, sometimes 4 are too many, but I might only want those students to rotate through 3 stations or 4 stations, and so I'll have 2 groups of 3 stations or 2 groups of 4 stations so that the groupings can be small enough. And those of you that do not know of Colin Dodds, he has some really good YouTube videos that correlate to a lot of middle school content. Our kids love these videos. Both Sean and I show them pretty frequently, and we were speaking before our presentation today that our kids were actually having a competition as to who could sing one of the songs the loudest. So I'm going to be talking about the Pythagorean theorem here in a